Okay, today I'm going to be doing the opposite of the red hot nickel ball, and I'm going to be putting a 2-inch steel ball in liquid nitrogen, letting it get down to liquid nitrogen temperature, and then dropping it in water. And I'm going to be doing this experiment to show you that ice formation is actually exothermic. So water freezing actually gives off heat. Okay, let's put the ball in. Here we go. Whoa. So basically the heat from the ball is going into the liquid nitrogen and boiling it as the ball cools down. Okay, I think we're to liquid nitrogen temperatures now. The boiling's starting to slow down. All of the boiling is coming from the ground below and not the ball itself. So that means the ball has now become as cold as the liquid nitrogen. Okay, here we go. Whoa. So watch this again, this is really cool. As soon as I stick the ball in there, notice it starts to bubble. So what is actually bubbling? There's no more liquid nitrogen on the steel ball anymore. So why was it bubbling? Well, it's because remember that water has dissolved air in it. And as soon as water turns into a solid, it can't hold as much dissolved air. And so that's where the bubbles come from. So you can see this when you put water in your freezer and make ice cubes. The ice cubes become cloudy, and that's the dissolved air that was in the liquid water. As soon as it turns to a solid, it can't hold it in the water anymore, and so it comes out as little tiny bubbles. But if you freeze the water super fast, then basically all the air that was in that liquid water that's instantly turning to ice now has to bubble out somewhere. And so that is all the air that was in the water. It's really cool. So now that the ball is covered with ice, it's completely insulated the inside of it. So the ball is still really cold in there, colder than the ice itself. So what's cool is as I'm holding this, it's actually getting colder. You can see when I took it out, it was wet, but now it's completely dry. There's no liquid water on here anymore. That's because the ball inside is continually sucking the heat out of the ice and freezing any extra water that gets on it. So this is a good way to understand that ice freezing is actually an exothermic process, meaning that the ball that's inside of there is warming up as the ice freezes. And so the energy from the liquid water went into the ball, and when the energy from the liquid water went into the ball, then it froze the liquid water into solid water. And so that process actually gave off heat. And I actually showed this in a previous video. When you super cool water and stick a thermometer in it and then let it freeze, it'll actually show that the temperature increases to freeze it. And so the water freezing is actually exothermic. It releases energy. My guess is that the inside of this is still at very cold temperatures. To test it, let's knock off the ice around it and see if it still freezes water. Oh, it looks like it's above freezing now. Oh, it's still forming a thin layer of ice around it. So it's just barely above freezing now. So this ball has now heated up warm enough to hold. So the only heat that this ball saw was the heat that came from water turning into ice. And so the water turning into ice is actually what warmed this up. So this proves that water turning to ice is actually exothermic, meaning it gives off heat, the same way that combustion is exothermic. An easy way to see this is I'll get my super cooled water, I'll put my thermometer in it, and then I'll hit it and it will freeze, and you'll see that the thermometer temperature increases when it freezes. So it's really weird to think about it that way, that as the water freezes, it heats up. Okay, so I'm going to try to measure the temperature without making it freeze. Oh, it froze. Okay, there it went. And the temperature is going up. So it was at negative 2.2, now it's going up. Only negative 0.9. Negative 0.4. So this is really weird. As it's freezing, it's warming up. Kind of opposite of what you'd expect.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching another episode of the Action Lab. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, remember to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell to be notified when my latest video's out, and head over to theactionlab.com if you haven't yet to check out the new Action Lab subscription box. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.